I'm Ms. Castanon, proud principal here at Summit High School. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America
and to the republic
which stands one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may now be seated.
Good morning, Skyhawks. Today is Friday, January 21st, 2022. I'm Annabella Lopez, and you're watching Skyhawk News. Bottled water. Bottled water is available each morning at both thermal scanner entrances. If you want water during the day, you can use this bottle at the water filling stations located around the campus. Textbook and novel return. Attention all students, if you have textbooks or novels that you are no longer using, return them to the library to avoid a fine. The public library will be closed through January 28th. Father-daughter dinner is on February 19th from 7 p.m. to 11 p.m. Tickets are only $25 for both. Get your ticket with the bookkeeper or online before we sell out. Seniors, save these dates. Prom is on April 2nd, grad night is on May 20th, and senior picnic is on May 25th. Buy your tickets with the bookkeeper. The last call to buy a senior t-shirt and or sweatshirt is January 21st. The t-shirts are $20 and the sweatshirts are $30. Hey Summit cross country runners, many of you have not turned in your uniforms yet, and if you don't want a charge placed on your account, you must turn your uniform into Coach Griffith before this Friday. If you are interested in running track this spring, there will be physicals after school on January 26th in the Hall of Fame. The cost is $15 and you must have all other paperwork filled out and signed before it will be accepted. See Coach Griffith or Coach Duncan if you have questions. Thank you. Track and field. Anyone interested in track and field this year will be a 15-minute meeting after school this Friday in E103. If you have any questions, see Miss Duncan. I wonder what this week's Linked Up is about. Let's check it out.
So if you guys are struggling, you can reach out to your link leaders. If you don't know who your link leaders are, you can come to C104, talk to Ms. Karpinski, and we'll set you up with one-to-one help. And also, we have the homework center.
Hey guys, I'm Jessie. I'm in link crew. Link crew will be calling any freshmen who failed at least one class first semester. And we just want to support you guys in order for you guys to graduate on time and to make sure that you guys pass second semester as well. And I'll see you guys later. Bye.
Get rid of your distractions, stay focused, and a little bit of work right now will pay off because you'll get credit for your classes, you'll graduate, and you won't be stressing about what assignments due next week or how you did on that last test.
Senior superlative?
Man, let me see that.
It says senior superlatives. What is this anyway?
I don't even know, man. I think yearbook wants us to submit, like, which senior is most fit for those positions, you know?
Yup. Yeah.
Yeah, these are all me. They fit my description.
What do you mean?
No, you can't be all of them.
Come on.
Most athletic.
Most evolved? I don't know what that is. That's gotta be me. Most likely to be famous. Extra star, baby. Most tech savvy. Control C, Control Plus. Plus my computer got RGB lights. Most likely to brighten day. I'll just buy you a couple light bulbs.
I don't know, man. Kinda making my days darker.
Worst case of senioritis? I'm supposed to be in school right now. Most artistic? Have you seen my room?
You need to leave!
Oh, I get it, and the class clown, most likely to succeed. If I don't get that one, it's because I'm already succeeding. Most drip, come on, bro, every day. Most likely to change the world. Psst. Hey.
Hey.
Mask. Put on your mask.
Oh, I just lost everything. I can't even afford a mask.
You don't got one? What kind of making my business look bad? Thank you.
Your boss, business owner, I'm the best at making money off people, bro. Most school spirit, go Seahawks. Done, bro.
Let's see how our Skyhawks would do on a pop quiz on this week's Getting Schooled.
Maria Genesis. Spell professor.
What's 9 times 8? 9 times 8? 7? No. And 60, 20,
who are you? 22!
Hey Skyhawks, I'm AJ Brown, and I'm here to catch you up with a little sports. Our girls basketball team competed against Eisenhower last Thursday and won 65-58. Way to pull out the win, ladies. They also played against Arroyo Valley and won 71-22. Let's take a look with an all-access and see how they dominated on the court. Come support your seniors as their senior night is Monday, January 24th at home. Our boys basketball team played Monday and unfortunately lost against Walnut. Shake it off, guys. You'll get them next time. Unfortunately, our boys did not play Tuesday due to cancellation from the other team. Come support our seniors as their senior night is next Thursday, the 27th at 6. Our girls' water polo team won against Carter 5-0. Let's take a look at this week's Athlete of the Week.
Chelsea Flacio, and I've been on varsity for 1 year, and I'm this week's Athlete of the Week. It feels rewarding because a lot of time and effort goes into your sport, so having a reminder of what you're working for is really nice. I joined water polo because swimming requires a lot of endurance, which is something that water polo improves a lot and helps you get really good at. My goals for this season are to have my team and I go to CIFs, and also to finally get a better understanding of water polo, since it is my first year, and so I have a wider view and what to base my techniques off. Our team had a few struggles in the beginning, but I believe that we are getting stronger by the months and by the times that we keep practicing. I'd shout out Viviana and my coach, my whole entire team for always being there, and my parents.
Way to show them how we Skyhawks get it done. Great work, ladies. Our boys' soccer team played against Bloomington last Thursday and won 4-0. Some of the games got canceled this week for unforeseen reasons, but will be scheduled again at a later time. Well, that's all I have for this week, Skyhawks. I'm AJ Brown, and I'm happy to have been able to assist you guys today. See you guys on the court.
Well, that's all I have for this week, Skyhawks. I'm Annabella Lopez, and this has been Skyhawk News.
As we soar through the ages, as we take to the skies, we spread our wings of blue and silver, as we fly with Skyhawk pride. Loyal in our hearts, body, spirit, mind, we come, we learn, we lead the way, forever summit high.
First, it was the Macintosh, then the iPhone, then the AirPods. Here at Apple, we strive to revolutionize technology and make the best products possible, which is why we are now introducing the iBot.
Hi, I'm Steve Robbs, and I'm proud to show you Apple's newest product, the iBottle. You might be thinking, why a water bottle? Our answer is simple, money. You see, the bottle itself is just like any other Apple product. It's sleek, it's durable, and incredibly expensive. You might think, this doesn't make any sense. Well, that's because it makes dollars. Millions of dollars. Now let's go over its revolutionary features. With our anti-theft feature, you will no longer need to worry about strangers stealing a sip out of your bottle. With our advanced safety technology, iBottle's lids scan each owner's lips. With Lip ID, you won't need to worry about the bottle unlocking itself to random individuals that aren't you. When unidentified lips are placed on the bottle, the lid will send a light shock throughout that person's body. With our science research, we were able to find a way to clean out any form of liquid to become water. I know what you're thinking, and yes, the iBottle can make fresh water out of your own urine. But make sure it's charged, because this will not work if... Just like every Apple product, the iBottle is Bluetooth. Connect your devices to the bottle to listen to all your favorite songs. Make sure the iBottle is empty before connecting the devices, as the bottle will short circuit and explode.
Wait, what?
If you're not convinced yet, take a look at what our satisfied customers had to say.
Can't live without it.
It's my favorite thing to carry around.
It's always convenient.
So when it comes to price, we looked at our many competitors. You have the normal everyday $20 bottles and Hydro Flask that could cost up to $50. Well, we thought there's no way we would let our customers spend that much. So you can get the iBottle for a low, low price of $10,000. And this wouldn't be Apple if we didn't mention two other versions of the product that are practically the same, but more expensive. So make sure to also check out the iBottle Pro and the iBottle XXL Pro Max SEY. Apple, because you will literally buy whatever we put out. All right, cool, that's a wrap. Thanks, guys, really. Oh, hey, boss.
Hey, what the hell is this thing? I give you $10 million and you make me a damn water bottle?
I think it's really gonna-
No, listen! Disappointment to the whole company! I don't hope you choke on your pee bottle!
Okay, bye. I don't know what he's talking about. This thing works just fine. Yup, that's definitely urine.